A reference image in Blender is like another object in the scene, so to add it, we can do Shift A to get this window, and here in the image section, we have the reference image object. So here we select the image we need, and there, as you can see, we already have the reference image placed in the scene. The problem here is that it's been created according to the orientation of the camera at that moment, so if we need, for example, the image in the front view, we should first configure the camera in the front view, for example pressing 1 on the numpad, and then add the reference image. That way, the image will be oriented in the XZ plane. Another thing we may need is that the image has some transparency so we can see what is behind. For that, we need to go to the image properties. With the image selected, go to this icon here, click on this opacity box, and lower it to the value you need, for example 0.2. As I said before, this image is as if it were another object in the scene. It can be scaled, it can be rotated, it can be moved, we can duplicate it. For example, here I will duplicate it, I will rotate it 90 degrees with respect to the Z axis, and I will make it show another different image. And for that, here in the properties of the image, I will click on this icon to open a second image. Then I'm gonna flip this image so that it looks to the other side, simply by rotating it 180 degrees with respect to the Z axis. And with this, we would have configured the reference images for the front view and the side view. Another thing that could be useful is to deactivate the reference images while we are in the perspective view. If we select the image, go to the image properties, and click on this perspective box, now the image will not appear in the perspective view, but it will appear in the orthographic view. Finally, another thing that could be useful is, once the image is already configured, lock the image so that it cannot be selected, and therefore stay out of the way while we are working. For that, we go to this icon here, and we will activate this option. With the image selected, uncheck this box, and that will make that the image can no longer be selected. So that's all for this video, I hope you found it useful, and see you in the next one. Tschüss!